JT Daniels on Thursday kind of rocks the whole world of college football. That was insane. And then
old Scoops Roos over there figuring out where JT Daniels is crossing the country.
Somebody on the board asked, do we want to call it a Roos bomb going forward? No, I'm fine with that. We can accept that term.
I think it's a good pickup. I think you're looking at it as a bridge type player. I think you see Newman this year. You see Daniels in 2021, and then work Vandegrift in slowly. I saw somebody post, you don't want Vandegrift starting against Clemson as a freshman in the 2021 season, which is very true.
Kirby Smart is going to play the best player possible. I understand that. But I do think that Newman, with the leadership that he's got, with the experience that he's got under his belt, and how he fits into this offense kind of seamlessly, first thing I think kind of makes him the fit.
JT Daniels looks like a gunslinger. And a piece of that is because he's got some funky arm angles at points, because he's got the power to generate a really strong pass pretty much from his hip if he needs to, which is the definition of a gunslinger. He can do some things that most quarterbacks just cannot do.
Just what kind of player is Georgia getting in Fairchild?
I mean, the first thing that stands out to me is he's not a type offensive lineman that Sam Pittman might have recruited. Sam Pittman might have been recruited, but he's the more... he's just athletic. I mean, he is. I think he's a guy that you could play at tackle if you can have a crunch up. He is probably going to play on the inside. He's athletic. He's strong as ox. He went like 48-0 last year in wrestling.
When you watch that film, man, this kid is aggressive. That's the big thing that jumps off the screen to me. He is a play through the whistle. I want to throw you on the ground, and then I want to sit on top of you, and I want to embarrass you. Kind of lineman, and I love that about a guy, especially with a wrestling background.
Whenever you can keep a talented offensive lineman in the state, especially, that's really crucial for Matt Luke to be building those relationships with coaches and being able to make his mark among these high schools in the state of Georgia, because it's an area that, yeah, he recruited some when he was at Ole Miss, but it's just a different thing when you're the home state school, right?
The biggest thing, though, and I think that this is probably something that has to excite Kirby Smart as much as anything about that kid's game, is when you just see him come up and run support and just stick a man at the offensive, right at the line of scrimmage. That's something that Kirby values in those guys. He wants guys that are going to get in there, be physical, be aggressive, and not just play sometimes. We see a lot of finesse from the cornerbacks, obviously, and some guys, that's their thing. But I think Groves Killebrew looks like a guy who can do a little bit of it all.
Georgia getting a victory in the Grayson-Snellville area, that's been kind of touchy, to say the least. That's a big deal.
He reminds me a lot of like Devon Wilson, the way they can come up and run support and also cover. I think he could play. He's a Kirby Smart type guy. He can play three or four different positions and excel at them all because his hitting ability and his coverage skills.
And this is for class of 2021. Do you see any potential attrition in terms of what this looks like for a scholarship limit coming up? So that's kind of what you guys crunch the numbers on of where's Georgia at in terms of total scholarships. And that changes when you get a surprise like a JT Daniels.
Kirby's going to take the max he can get every single year, and he's going to work the numbers out. It'll work out. I don't know how he does it sometimes, and then, I mean, I don't care how he does it. Sometimes it's better not to know.
I sure as hell don't understand George's fuzzy math in order to get all these kids in. I don't know how they're taking 25 and 26 a year. I don't know how they're massaging the numbers for it. I don't know how you're moving guys out, but it's happening. And like Trent said, until I see otherwise, I think Georgia is going to shoot for 25 in this class and every class.